Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is a rare privilege, and you have made it a very special evening for me. I mean, there are people like Mr. Bajaj and Mr. Bhargava and Mr. Ramadu Rai and such lovely people, Mr. Mariwala and Pavan Goenka and everybody here I've met, and I think so many other people that I look forward to meeting. And I believe that corporate India is probably, in my opinion, part of the big ecosystem that makes this country great. Let's celebrate this great country, because you, ladies and gentlemen, are deserving of it more than anybody else.
Thank you, sir. Any questions and answers?
You have seen both the corporate side and the political side. I think you are in a vantage position to have actually seen both the worlds.
That's true. Yeah.
How do you maintain the equilibrium, or call it the sanity, having lived this world and this world, and kind of still manage to kind of survive? Thank you.
What I believe, you know, from the corporate to the politics, I want to let everybody know here, politics is not half as bad as it's made out to be. You know, you will find me being critical of BJP or BJP being critical of us. But I think there are good people on all sides. And I do believe that every party has got its own roadmap to take India forward. We differ in that. I mean, we are ideologically incompatible with the BJP. They have their own way of doing things. We have our own way of doing things. I think politics is something where I would love to see professionals get into it. And the reason why I say that is because you influence policy. You know, when I think about it, I'm not going to make any public disclosure, but you make policies that can affect industry. Well, that's big. If you can affect, say, create a MGNREGA construct, it affects millions of lives. MGNREGA is the biggest social security scheme in the world. You know, so the import of what you do is simply phenomenal. And I think if you're driven by a commitment to serve, I think you're on a high when you're in politics. I'll be honest, it's also a tragedy that many people join politics because for them it's about a quick buck and it's about making money. You know, there is an MLA stock exchange, you buy and sell what you like. Well, that's terrible. So I do believe Indian politics is battling these inner contradictions. But to answer your question in short, because I would love to hear more questions, I do believe my transition has been the best thing I've ever done.
How can we have one India, one vision, and with one objective?
I believe in politics, we have a very tough job. We have to make sure that you're motivated, you get the incentives, you get the infrastructure for, or the skill talent that you need to grow. At the same time, what are you going to do with 250 million people living below the poverty line? It's very tough for the Congress. I'm sure it's very tough for Mr. Modi. So these are easier said than done. So I believe India's success will lie, besides, it's a no-brainer. We can't afford to do this polarized politics. I need to be very upfront about that. I think the BJP is committing serious suicide by encouraging this politics of majoritarian nationalism. It might win you elections, but you damage the country in the long term. But that's not for me to advise them. Good luck, they're winning elections. But these don't last forever, I can tell you that. The cost that the country pays is usually imperceptible. You don't see it. You don't see it. The country pays a price in terms of a damage which is happening socially. As an economy, I do believe that India has struggled. You know, when I read that story, I don't know how many of you are aware, in New Delhi last year, a family of four died out of starvation in Delhi. And the three girls were aged 8, 4, and 6. And they hadn't eaten for 8 days. And you know, when I then read about people complaining about Nyay and all that, I was like, I was appalled. It hurt me. It hurt me. Honestly, it did. Because that's a fellow Indian. Tabriz Ansari, who gets lynched, is a fellow Indian. You can't watch that video. So, you know, I do believe it doesn't matter who we are, where we come from. But we got to realize that, you know, if we feel so passionately about India losing a match or winning a match in the World Cup, come on, for God's sake, let's rise for each other. You know, we need to do that. It doesn't matter, young or old, man or woman, Hindu, Muslim, Christian, Sikh, Jain, whatever. But we can't afford to make these narrow parochial issues into the national headline. Sadly, that's what's becoming at the moment the, you know, the daily, shall we say, political discourse. But the public has to change that. You have to change it. And I'm very bullish on corporate India. I believe corporate India has such phenomenal minds. If you can't change it, then don't expect others to do that. And the fact is, who pays to fund the bureaucracy? The corporate sector does. And I think corporate India must earn its respect back. And I don't know, whatever I can do or my party can do, we will do our best for you.
Well, this 55 years that Congress was there, you couldn't pass a bill which was passed in Pakistan in 1957 or something, the triple talaq bill. Secondly, in the last 5 years, we have not seen any major terror attack, which we saw during your time, unfortunate.
A triple talaq bill is made out to be as if it is the ruling party's big, you know, liberal attitude. Well, please go and ask them, why have 49 lynching deaths happened in this country in the last 5 years? No answers. No answers. And please also need to fundamentally ask this question, that hasn't happened, by the way. The PIL went to the Supreme Court, not by the BJP. It was filed by an independent NGO. You're just taking credit for it. So I don't think we want to go down that road at all. I believe the larger point in India is that we are a victim of fake news and post-truth. I'll give you that example on terror. You said there have been no terror attacks in the last 5 years. So what was Pathankot? What was Uri? What was Gurdaspur? Now, the BJP comes and says there has been no terror attack and India is safe. I'll tell you why that's complete balderdash. And here, I need to give you a political response because that is a political question. Ladies and gentlemen, whether you are in Kashmir or whether you're in Punjab or Maharashtra or Andhra, it is a part of India. Now, the BJP says that what happens in Jammu and Kashmir is not a terror attack. Isn't Jammu and Kashmir part of India, for heaven's sake? And after today, I believe more so. What about Punjab? Because I'll tell you what the perception is created. That Malegaon is in Maharashtra. That what happened in Hyderabad is in Andhra. And therefore, there were some terror attacks that happened during the UPA phase in Maharashtra, in Pune, in the German bakery. And you'll probably be aware of what happened in Hyderabad and also Ajmer. Now, that is posted as if that is pan-India and therefore only the UPA is responsible. But can I be blunt here and tell you the truth? Find out who were the people who were responsible for those terror attacks. And you will find, to your surprise, that the initial investigations led to the arrest of people who belonged, sadly, to some of our own locally manufactured members of the larger right-wing fundamentalists. Is Sanatan Sanstha not responsible for the death of Pansare? For Dabulkar? Are you aware that in Maharashtra, just 6 months ago, there was a complete bomb-making terror activity being done where people were arrested linked to the Sanstha? I think it's terribly unfair. I'm glad my party does not stoop to that debate. But I also want to concede, maybe we are losing the debate because we are not taking these issues head on. Because the fact is, terror attacks have happened like insane during the time. Security forces killed, civilians killed have run into the biggest numbers under the regime of Mr. Modi. I can give you the rough numbers. 383 people were security and around 275 were civilians. And that number, by the way, has gone up. Pulwama, who's responsible for it? Is the country going to ask? 45 of our soldiers died. Is somebody going to ask that question? Is that not a terror attack? So these are bigger issues, ladies and gentlemen. I'm glad you're asking me these tough questions.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Let's give a round of
applause. Thank you very much.